I would like to now talk about my paintings from the Chianti region of Italy, which I started painting probably in around 2003, 2004, and continued to up through 2019. Now, the first two landscapes that I actually painted were not from the Chianti region. We discussed them earlier, Tranquillo and Nipozzano. They were from the Nipozzano winery, which is right outside of Florence. Chianti is a special region. There are five or six towns that are in this area. It's similar to the 17-mile drive, I think, in California. Castellina in Chianti, Rada in Chianti, Panzano Valley in Chianti, Greve in Chianti. Greve is actually the closest. Gaioli in Chianti. There's several beautiful areas. And I'd like to begin, before I get in talking about the actual painting of Panzano Valley, which is one of the very first ones I did, I would like to read this corresponding critique which we're showing from Sister Wendy Beckett. Now, I mentioned to you before, Sister Wendy Beckett was at the time, and still probably, she passed away, unfortunately, in December of 2018, but she was regarded as one of the top art historians in the world. She's a cloistered nun that spends most of her time at the convent in Norfolk, and in the village of Quindedom in Norfolk. It's a Carmelite monastery, but she does come out to the public about once a year, which she started doing in the late 80s, to review, visit museums and discuss them. She had two very successful TV shows and on the BBC network and PBS, and has written about 25 books on art and art history. Again, in certain circles, regarded as one of the top art historians on the planet, and she discovered my work, as we mentioned earlier, when she saw the painting Tranquillo that was in an art news ad. But most of the time over my career, when we started communicating with each other, she would write simple 1, 2, 3 sentence quotes about or statements about my paintings. This, however, the Panzano Valley Chianti painting really inspired her to write something special. You can see it up in the board, but I'm just going to read the first couple of sentences because it's a great introduction to my landscapes from this region, in landscapes in general. Here's the beginning of the quote. You can read it along, but I'll just read about the first half. A true landscape painting does not tell us precisely what a certain landscape looks like, or at least not only that. What it tells us, if this does not sound extravagant, is what a landscape means, what its individual power and beauty. The painter sees what is before him. He takes it into himself, understands and loves it, then recreates for us the double reality of what he sees and what he feels. Cézanne, to whom William Kelley is spiritual son, called it his petite sensation, quote, his reaction, the response that he and he alone could make. Kelley loves the Chianti region. The very word brings to mind the lovely wine it produces, and he spends many months every year contemplating its contours and colors, its agriculture and vegetation, its vineyard and homesteads. He is celebrating the richness of the natural world and the infinitely satisfying order into which it has been brought by human labor and intelligence. I won't read the rest of it. I think that's a pretty powerful statement, particularly when she makes the statement that I am a spiritual son to Cézanne, who she regarded as one of the greatest painters ever. I found that I was very humbled by that statement. So now we can just talk about the painting itself. Again, Panzano Valley is in Chianti. It's this beautiful area that is, as you can see, it's just has everything that the whole Chianti region is all about. And I love the contours in this painting. I love the composition. Again, with all my landscapes, I sort of exaggerate some of the colors because I always feel that the colors in one painting reflect a 24-hour period of color, and I just try and get it down at one particular time. But then again, in this one, you have the beautiful hills in the background, you have the trees, the cypress trees, the contoured fields, the Tuscan fields. And again, one of the first landscapes that I did, and I learned the painting of the fields. The color of the Tuscan earth is pretty much flesh colored, and I was taught that by one of my teachers, Claire Gabrunski, at the Lorenzo de' Medici School. So you'll see in the three different areas here, the sort of the fields are very flesh colored. And again, the rows and rows of olive trees that are planted and the grapes. It's just this painting to me has an incredible feeling, and it's, as Sister Wendy stated, it's not just what I see or what the landscape painter sees, but it's also what he feels. I believe that the best way to finish the discussion on the Panzano Valley painting in front of us is to go back to the critique written by Sister Wendy Beckett. And she continues, again, discussing this painting. "We love, as of all former generations, at a time of war and sadness, bloodshed and disaster, to have set before us a testimony to the things that do not go amiss. The warmth and sweetness of the world, which exists as certainly as the pain and cold. In Panzano Valley, the neat ordered lines of the vineyards, the exquisite patternings of the trees, the noble slopes of the hills, the long diagonals of the most heavenly pinks and shades of green, all are alive with an inner joy that Kelley has sensed and made visible. This is in no way a religious picture, but is a profoundly spiritual one, a strong and gentle praise of the soil and its fruit, the reverent collaboration of man and nature, both creatures of a loving God. We long for order, we must labor for it. We long for beauty, we must seek for it." Thank you, Sister Wendy Beckett. Panzano Valley, again, as I mentioned before, is a 5 by 6 foot painting, as you see here. And then below this, you see another painting, which is a very similar composition, but extremely larger. And this painting is called Tuscan Soul. As you see, I'm standing next to it. And this painting is approximately 7 by 15.5, 16 feet. Now, I'd like to tell you a little bit story of why I decided to paint this larger version. I had finished Panzano Valley in 2004, and I continue to paint many, many landscapes in the Chianti and Tuscan region of Italy. But I always had in the back of the mind that at some point I would like to challenge myself and go a lot bigger. And there's a little history behind this. When Susan and I were living full-time in Florence between 2004 and 2009, we did quite a bit of traveling throughout Europe. And in 2007, in the spring, we took a trip to St. Petersburg, Russia, from Florence. And I had both of us had always wanted to go to the Hermitage Museum, which is one of the most famous on the planet. And we finally had our wishes, and we went there primarily because we knew the painting of Henri Matisse, The Dance, was in the Hermitage because it had been commissioned by a Russian businessman back at the turn of the 20th century. So that was our main purpose. We knew there were a lot of Impressionists and other masterpieces, of course, which we had seen in the Uffizi and other places. But we really wanted to see the dance. And as you see, this is quite a colorful image, but it's also a very large painting. It's approximately 9 feet by 13 feet, one of the biggest ones that Matisse had ever done. Subsequent to being at the Hermitage, we met a person through a friend in Florence who was a guide. She suggested we needed to go to the Russian Museum, and we didn't really know much about that. And she says, well, you don't know much about Russian painters because people in the West, you may have been taught, she was kind of interesting. She said, you may have been taught to read Crime and Punishment or War and Peace, you know, Dostoevsky or Tolstoy, but you probably never heard of any of the Russian artists that were living at that time in the mid-19th century. Most people in the West, Europeans and American, only knew about the modern painter Manet, and then the Impressionists and Monet, and then the Post-Impressionists and Cezanne and Van Gogh. But you never heard of any Russian painters, and you must come and see these. And she said, I challenge you. I think you'll see that Ilya Repin, R-E-P-I-N, is probably one of the greatest painters of all time. So at any rate, we did go to the Russian Museum, and I was amazed at the talent that was there. It is true. There were other painters, Ivan Shishkin, Valentin Serov. We had never heard of them, and they had some incredible paint. Also, some very, very giant paintings. Now, this particular painting, Repin's Cossack's painting, is 7 feet by 12 feet. There were other paintings in the gallery, some were as much as 13 by 30 feet, but it was just an overwhelming group of paintings. And again, I'm thinking I'd never done anything this large. So we were very, very moved by what we saw in St. Petersburg at both the Hermitage and the Russian Museum. But the thing that really closed the deal for me was a year later, 2 years later, when on a surprise trip, Susan took me to Paris in February of 2009 to celebrate my birthday. And it turned out our good friend and one of my big collectors, Brian Johnson, who's with the group AC/DC, were playing in Paris on my birthday, and Susan had gotten tickets for it. But we were there for a week. And we spent a lot of time, in addition to seeing my friend Brian and his group, we actually went to some of our old haunts, Montmartre, and we ended up going to the Musée de Lingerie, where Monet's giant paintings, specifically the water lilies, were on exhibit. And this was basically the thing that I made up my mind. I said, I have to do this. I have to paint big. Now, this particular Monet painting here, the one of the water, is 2 by 5 meters, which is approximately 7 by 16 feet. So I told Susan, when we get back to Florence, I'm going to do a giant painting. So now, back to Tuscan Soul. This is the painting that I decided to do after seeing some of these very large paintings. And the reason I picked this particular scene is I was very comfortable with my Tuscan and Chianti landscapes. So I figured if I'm going to do something this big, I have to feel confident in the actual subject matter. And I did this mostly from, I did have some photographs of this original painting, the original 5 by 6 painting, but it was mostly done by my imagination, based on my history of doing this particular scene in Panzano Valley. So it gets kind of humorous because my art supply store is called Zecchi, Z-E-C-C-H-I, and they've been in family business in Florence for many, many years. And I had been a customer for about 10 years, and I had been friendly with the owner, Massimo, but not really socially friendly. We were just friends when I would talk to him when we were buying paintings and paint and canvases. So I went in and I asked him if I could order this 2 by 5 meter canvas. And he just looked at me because it was literally twice as big as anything I've ever done. And he said, so what are you going to do with this? And I said, Massimo, I'm going to paint a really big painting. He thought at one point I might be, you know, cutting it up and doing several paintings. Well, he was very curious, and this was in September of the year, 2009. And he said, would it be okay if I came to your studio when you're close to finish or finished with this? And I said, sure, it'll probably be a little before Christmas, and it's going to take about 3 months. So sure enough, late November, I went to the shop and I said to Massimo, I'm ready. I'm ready for your viewing. And so we made an appointment. And at that time, my studio, I had a new studio. I had left the Ponte Vecchio after 5 years. And I had a studio on Boulevard Albizzi, which was on the street level. And it was pretty big and actually very close to Massimo's art supply store. So on the appointed date, he came down and he saw pretty much this finished product. And he got very emotional. And he said, you know, I'm a Florentine and we love Florence, but we have our issues. And specifically, there's a lot of air pollution, smog in Florence. And so on weekends, he and his wife and his children, they would ride around bicycles around this particular area in Panzano Valley. So he knew it well. In fact, he had just been riding around the previous weekend. And then in beautiful Italian, he told me that this was his soul, mia anima. And I just said, well, that's a wonderful expression. I think you just titled my painting. So I call this Tuscan Soul, and I owe it the title to my good friend Massimo Secchi. Now, this painting was finished in 2009. I had it shipped back to the States. Actually, I had to finish it back in my studio in 2000, where it still is. I've never done anything this big, and when I started to paint it, I never had any intentions of or thinking of where I would sell it or who would buy it. It was just something, a personal challenge that I really felt I was up for, and I did it. We have not sold the painting. It's still in my studio. On the other hand, the Panzano, the original Panzano Valley, which is 5x6, sold almost immediately at my my show in 2005 at the Walter Wickizer Gallery. And it was purchased by Bob and Catherine Carr of Sarasota, Florida. Thank you.